Welcome in the Universe community. Our topic for today is how can being in the now help us? Now we keep on doing our work every day, but you know, there is no sense of peace. Our mind keeps chattering about everything. We have problems to take care of. We have so many things. We already have much in our life, but somewhere we just do not know why we don't feel at peace. So today we are going to find out ways in which you can become more peaceful. And one of the major ways you can feel peace in your life is by being in the here and now, by being aware in this moment, in this present moment, which is called a gift. This present moment is all that you have. This present moment is where you are creating your life for tomorrow. So let us know more about how being in this now, in this present moment, can make our lives more peaceful. Now you see, we are conditioned to believe that if you work now, then your life will become better in the future. If you work hard now, your relationships will improve. If you work hard now, you'll get rich. And so we keep working hard now with all the problems in our life, and that future never arrives. How does it happen? The thing is, when you think that someday I'll become rich, someday my relationships will improve, someday everything will be fine, this is the energy you're exuding, the energy of someday. And now when the universe taps into your now vibrations, because it always sees how you are feeling now, it taps on to your emotions in the present moment, in the now. So your now vibrations are: this person is going to become rich one day or someday. This person is going to finish this work someday, and that someday doesn't arrive. Tomorrow it will again be someday. Day after tomorrow again it is someday. So that is why you keep striving but you don't arrive. Now what do you do about it? You have to feel the emotion of whatever you want in this present moment. You have to feel like you will feel when you have actually received it. Now you feel like that, as if you have already attained your desire. How do you feel now? You feel elated and very happy, and now this is the vibration you are exuding, and so all your desires will come faster, because your now vibrations are one of success. Your now vibrations are one of elation, of happiness, joy, and you know, all the bright and good vibrations. And now when the universe taps into your now vibrations, it sees this person is actually really happy. So let me give him or her more happiness. And this is how your vibrations are such that whatever you desire, it will always come faster to you. It will manifest faster. In a universe community, there are always two of you. This is your physical self, and then there is your inner being. What happens is your inner being is always connected with you all the time. It feels abundance. It feels your success. But your outer, this physical being, is always striving. Its focus is always directed on the outside, and you are never connected with your inner being. Now, as you become more silent and meditative, and as you go inside your body, you know, and you connect with this life-giving force in your body, this energy field inside your body, that is how you can connect with your inner being. Now you become more intuitive. Now problems don't feel like problems, because now your focus has shifted towards solution, and all the answers come easy to you. So it is not that you never connect with your inner being. You do connect with your inner being for short intervals of time, like when you pray, when you are appreciative of anything whatever you see around in your life and you appreciate it. When you are happy and joyful, then you are connecting with your inner being, because your inner being is always happy. So these are short intervals of time when you actually connect with your inner being. Now, your job is to make this interval more prolonged. How can you prolong this connection with your inner being? You can do this by being in the now, by being in this present moment. When you are creative, that is also the time when you are connected with your inner being, because your whole body is into that work. It is not working from your mind. Your whole body is so much into that work. You are putting in so much of love in that work. You are being creative. You are inspired during that time. And this is the time when you are connected with your inner being. Let us know a few more instances, a few more ways how you can connect with your inner being, how you can be in the now. It is all right to focus on the outside world and take your logical decisions, but then come back and be aligned with your inner being. And the more aligned you are throughout the day, the better decisions you will make and the more peaceful you will feel. Now, the first way of being in the here and now is that whenever you see anything outside, just become a witness to that. Whatever you hear or see, you just become a witness to that. Just become an observer. Don't judge it as good and bad, nice or not nice. Don't judge it. Just become a witness to it. So that is how you will not be perturbed by anything that is happening on the outside. The second way to be completely present in the now is to be into what you are doing. Just concentrate into whatever you are doing. The third way is to keep silent and become more meditative and enter a no thought zone. When you are silent, no negative inputs are coming from the outside. And now you are an observer, and again, no negative inputs, no judgmental thoughts are coming. And the more you are in the no thought zone, your mind is completely silent. And this you have to actually practice every day. Through practice, you can attain this no thought zone. And then you will be totally in the here and now. Your constant chatter in the mind that keeps taking place, it ceases. The fourth way of being in the present moment is by not going into the past or into the future very often. Don't go there too often unless and until you actually need to go. All that you have is the present moment, so create in this moment, because you are creating your life through your vibrations in this present moment. Even when you become very aware as to whether you are actually in this present moment or not, you are in the present moment, because only then you will know whether you are in the past or in the future, or you are doing right by being in the present moment. Check your emotions, because your emotions mirror what is going on inside. If you are in the present moment, you will feel very peaceful. If you are in the past or in the future, you will feel anxious, and your emotions will tell you what exactly is going on in your mind. So watch your emotions so that your old patterns are not repeated. Your old pattern of behavior is not repeated. Another way to be in the now is to watch your breath. As you inhale and exhale, just watch your breath, because you will know if there is any change in your emotions. There will be a change in the pattern of your breath. Have you seen that when you are angry, you start breathing faster? Now there is change, upheaval in your emotions, and your breath changes. And so concentrate on your breath, concentrate on your emotions. They are a very good way of knowing what is going on in your inner being inside you, and they are a very good mirror of whether you are in this present moment or not. And yes, one really important way to be in the now is to sit and meditate at least for 15 minutes each day. Deliberately sit and imagine. Imagination is God. So imagine your life as you would like it to be. And now you are so present in the present moment. And you are imagining and creating your life deliberately. So imagine your life as you would like it to be. And now, you know, everything is as it should be. You do not have to improve on it. So you just live your life in peace and accept everything as it comes. And as you raise your vibrations, only good experiences will come your way. Only those people who elevate you, those who offer you opportunities, you will make your own opportunities. And only these circumstances will be created. Positive circumstances will be created for you, especially depending on the vibrations you are exuding. All your life problems take you away from your inner being. So as you concentrate on aligning yourself with your inner being, what happens is you are not taking care of the problems. The problems will take care of themselves. What you are doing is just keeping your alignment with your inner being, and you'll get the solutions there as you tap into your intuition. What happens is when you are not aligned with your inner being, you are so confused and you are always solving problems, unending problems, and you are not able to solve some of them. But as you align with your inner being, that is the source energy inside you, what happens is the problems take care of themselves. The answers come to you. Now you are at a vibration of the solution. The vibration of the solution is not the same as the vibration of the problem. And as you align with your inner being and with the vibration of the solution, all answers come to you. And you know, the problems take care of themselves. Your outer circumstances change. Where are the problems, you will ask? There are no problems. So now, as you make it a habit to practice all these things, what happens is you are more in the present moment than you were initially. Now you are more in the present moment, and the more you stay in the present moment, the more your vibrations become high. Now participate in all that is happening outside, but then give as much importance to what is happening inside. Give as much importance to whether you are constantly aligned with your inner being or not. Now, stress is caused only when you are too much into the past or you are anxious about the future. Now you know that you do not have to constantly wait for happiness. You can just be in gratitude in this present moment and enjoy peace. So being in the now also brings you into gratitude for whatever you already have. And then you enjoy so much of peace. You are satisfied in this present moment. And the only way to get into the next pedestal in your life, to go, to move towards your desires, is by being satisfied first where you are. By being appreciative of first where you are standing right now. You cannot complain and go to the next level. So learn to enjoy the journey, and you can enjoy the journey and then reach the destination simply enjoying it. If you have sowed the seed, the crop has to come. So there is no question why it will not come. Now it will come depending on the quality you have sowed. So as you sow, so shall you reap. But then it is in your own hands to enjoy the journey. Why not enjoy the journey? Learn all through the journey. There is so much to learn always. So keep learning, keep enjoying the journey as you tread towards the destination. That is your desires, your goals in life. and become more present in the now, because when you will reach the destination, you can only enjoy the fruits of your labor, of your hard work, of your determination, when you are present in the now. When you learn to be present in the now. How does being in now help us? As you become more aware and you become more present in the now, you will understand that there is a part of your being that actually revels in, you know, talking about pain. It revels in being unhappy and sad and to focus on all that is not good around you, all that is not good or going well in your life. But your focus in the present moment keeps you in gratitude, and this is how you gradually root out this pain body. You gradually root out this part of yourself that sulks, complains, and is constantly getting its energy from being unhappy. It will take a lot of work for you to do this, but gradually you will be able to root out this part of yourself as you shift towards being in more gratitude. So this complaining part will move away from your life. The great author Eckhart Tolle, in his book The Power of Now, says that direct your attention into your body and feel your body from within. Now go inside your body, feel that life-giving energy which resides in your body, and now see your body, feel your body from within. Eckhart Tolle says, direct your attention into your body and feel your body from within as a single field of energy. Become one, that is, merge with this energy field. Now the observer and the observed have become one. You are one with the source within you. This is why we say that you are a divine being. There is an energy field within you. And as you align, as you merge and become one with this energy field, and you travel inside with this energy field, you become light. You are the light. You become the divine energy that lies within you. Now, as you connect with this divine energy, this life-giving force within you, your consciousness raises to a different level. And now you are connected with this energy source most of the time. So what happens is that you feel lighter. You are so aware. You are present in the now. So now as you connect with this divine energy field inside you, as you connect with the inner being, what happens is, as you keep doing your work, you are no longer affected by the negativity outside you. Outside influences have no impact on you now, because now you have more clarity by being connected with your inner being. You are happier. Your inner being is always abundant. It is always happy. And as you merge with that inner being, you are also happy now. And all your work that you are doing, it is coming out from a center of creativity and love and peace. And so it will be beautiful work that you'll do. You'll get inspired. You'll get more ideas. And you'll be full of energy and full of life. You'll be happy all the time. So this is all in this video. Thank you so much, Inner Universe community. This is your mentor and spiritual guide, Sanchita Pandey. My message, as always, is I love you. My prayers are always, always with you. I wish you abundance, great health, happiness, and peace in your life. Namaste.